Mr. Tsering, 50 years have gone since Tibetans demonstrated against the Chinese occupation and the Dalai Lama fled to India. How do you see the future of your nation?
We live in hope. And as His Holiness always says, hope for the best, prepare for the worst. Today, China is in a position to dictate terms to the world. And Tibet, although in terms of landmass it is huge, but population is very small. And we are a minority in the sea of 1.3 billion Chinese people. And we are in a disadvantaged position. We have a very, very strong opponent. We don't call them our enemy. So just as China has risen, I'm sure there'll be a way for others also to live in peace, because how you always tend to wonder, how come you still have so much tyranny, so much repression, so much control on freedom with gun and force, even in the 21st century, when so much of humanity live in peace with each other, in freedom. So we are positive that things will change.
What does it mean being the president of a parliament in exile?
In name, it is quite big. In power, it's very less. But it is a real proud thing for us Tibetans. And personally, for me, I was born in India. I am the first speaker of the parliament who was born outside Tibet. And I have never seen Tibet. The closest I ever got to was the border between India and Tibet in Sikkim, just looking through the barbed wires, and then imagine, okay, that is my country. So I've never stepped in my land. So personally, I'm also a child of a poor farming family, one son out of 9 children. I'm the third. So by adopting democratic polity, even as farmer's son can become the speaker of the parliament, that itself is an achievement.
And after the Chinese government refused your proposal to give Tibet an autonomy status, do you think a change in your strategy is necessary or not?
They think they have given us autonomy, but they do not understand the concept of autonomy. Okay, we made a proposal. You don't agree with it. But you do realize that Tibet is a problem. You know, even after 50 years, in 2008, it was unprecedented peaceful demonstrations all over Tibet, which the whole world was witness to it. So realizing that Tibet is an issue that needs to be resolved, and if they don't agree with what we have said, at least they should come up with a counter proposal. Even that they are not willing to do.
And could the international community play a role in this?
The international community has played a major role from late 80s to now, and there is need for the international community to stand up on the principles, not just subjugate on economic benefit alone. And we believe that there should be good relations. The Dalai Lama always believed, and we also believe the same, that there should be better relation between China and the outside world, international countries. And through that, through friendship, not telling China, okay, you're doing bad, you're doing this bad, you are bad, but as friends, advise China that you have the military power now, you have political power, the only thing you lack is moral power. You know, so by resolving Tibetan issue, giving a little more freedom to Tibetans to preserve their language, culture, you know, environment, and religion.
And do you think that South Tyrol could be a good example for Tibet?
South Tyrol has always been an example, a model for us. So, the Dalai Lama always believed that if we get the kind of degree of autonomy that South Tyrol has, or the degree of autonomy that Scotland has, that should be good for Tibet. And why not? The only difference is, of course, South Tyrol is under a democratic country like Italy, and we are under an authoritarian country like China.